I'm Kahan Tazadaq, and my YouTube channel is a spokesman for men and women that love them. It's not that I'm against women, we're not against women, but it's because there's been no legal remedy. There's no outlet for men. I know a lot of men. I have a couple brothers recently that committed suicide. And you know what was that high point where he just felt as though he couldn't take it anymore? Same result from both brothers that I know. Huh? It was a woman that snatched away their children. Huh? Couldn't deal with their children anymore. Meanwhile, she's painting these bogus, fake court cases, alleging that this man is doing this to her and doing that to her when I know he's not even around him. And so the only thing that these brothers felt as they had left was their children. And she deliberately turned the children against him, used the children as weapons so he can't see his children anymore. And this goes on throughout America. The America judicial family court system is wicked and needs to be extirpated from society. These people know what's going on. The judges knows what's going on. The lawyers knows what's going on. The social service systems. It all needs to be revolutionized, which means complete constructive change. It needs an overhaul. And you need a true justice system. The skill of the justice is not blind. Because why? See, women really think that they're in some season of women power, right? Women empowerment. They do not realize that this full sense of empowerment came from men. See, there's a small faction of men, a global elite, and you can think I'm crazy all you want to, that wants to run the world. And so they tried every other method that has failed. They tried drugs. They tried putting drugs in the black community to destroy the black community. Why? Because they want to decrease society. Because these idiots believe that, okay, well, we're going to have an overpopulation here. And so we're not going to be able to feed everyone. So we got to eliminate a certain faction in society. So what they're doing, they're using a female psyche. And she really thinks she's in charge of this. But she's essentially just being used as a catalyst. And women, if you take it offensive, then hey, if I offended you, I meant to, because it's the truth and the truth needs no apology. So they use the female psyche to come against the man. They create this full sense of women empowerment, right? So in order for you to come in power, if someone's in power, right? In order for you to be in power, you have to overthrow that power structure for you to be in power, not for them to give you something. Because if someone's giving you something, that's a privilege. And you're still subservient to the one that's actually giving you these privileges like women's liberations, women's rights, and so on and so forth. So you use this because you're being used as a catalyst, as a liaison to destroy the family. And the family essentially has been the backbone of every nation there is. So if you could destroy the nation at its root, which is the family, then you could really control the world, right? And essentially, that's what's going on. And once your usefulness has expired, ladies, you're going to see that they never really cared about you. So they create something known as the best interest of the child, right? And I know a few brothers going through this right now that was extremely good fathers. They're still extremely good fathers. But you have these women that says, oh, my son. I don't want him to see my son. I feel it's a threat to my son. And this brother I know personally, he's an extremely good father. And out of nothing else other than the evil of her heart, she's trying to strip that child away from his father. And essentially now she's not allowing him to see the father. When the father goes over, she doesn't open the door. And this is pure evil. Then you have other women. I have two brothers that committed suicide over the past year and a half, right? You know why? Because women would not allow them to see their children. Now, you could call that weak, but when you feel as though you love your children so much that someone would come along and snatch them away and turn the child against you, because this is essentially what happened, and she was like just stripping his child away, I surmise he felt as though he couldn't take it anymore. And so he snuffed himself off. Huh? And so this is why the suicide rate is so high amongst men. It's at an inordinate rate. It's men that go to work every day, try to be good fathers, try to be good providers, and then a woman would create a bogus court case charge, right? Family court, the corrupt family court system, and say, oh, he raped me, or he striked me. But Then you have those that can't get that. And so they will create and try to provoke the man to hit them because they know they have nothing else. And some guys are so weak that they fall for. But I tell you something, brother, if a woman has any inclination that she's going to call the police on you, you leave her and never be with her again. The strongest negotiating position is to walk away and really mean it. I don't care how deep you think you're in love with her. When she becomes at eyes with you, the scriptures say all wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. And I'm not woman bashing. I'm telling the truth. And if the truth offends you, then I meant to, because the truth needs no apology. And ladies know that this is going on. Many of you women know that this is going on. So now you have this new influx of women that pretends, right? They pretend to be speaking out against what these women are doing, right? But they're only doing it for like social media fame. In fact, you don't really give a damn, because if you really give a damn, then you would really be taking some sort of legal action. You would really be trying to create something that will really try to change this system. This system needs to be uprooted and revolutionized. And what I mean by revolutionized, men and the women that love them need to come together to change this. Because, ladies, unbeknownst to you, the power doesn't come from you. You have no power. The power comes from this small faction of men that's governing the banking system, that controls the world, that controls government. And you can think I'm crazy all you want to, but I know guy day after day that's living this out. Remember, I'm a spokesman for men and women that love them. I have a YouTube channel, Kahan Tazadaq, right, on YouTube. And 78% of my subscribers are men. Why do you think that is? I have nothing against women. I love women. I love righteous Midas daughters that's willing to play her role in society for the betterment of mankind. And that starts with the institution of family. But if a man get involved today, I tell him, listen, brother, don't get married and do not impregnate that woman unless you know her for at least 3 years so you can fill her out. Why? Because a deck is stacked against men. The family court system is against men. With one lie before one judge, she could turn that man's life upside down. Men go to work and they work hard to try to provide a standard of living for their family, right? A man will work hard and she will go in with one lie. She will steal half of his pension, half of his pay, and even take his house. Now you tell me how that's justice. And the thing is, the system know that this is going on. The judges know it's going on. The lawyers know what's going on. The social work system know what's going on. It all needs to be extirpated and undone and redone. So my question to anyone that has anything negative to say about this particular video right here is, what are you doing to make a difference? Because you know this is going on. You have some Eves that's so naive that's saying, oh yeah, well, it's about time. Yeah, this is women's time and so on and so forth. But once your usefulness has expired, you're going to see that the system was never in favor of you. You understand? You're going to find that out the hard way, as so many do. The system is not in favor of you. It's not about the best interest of the child. You know, many times the father is the better parent. And statistically, if I know that, if I could go and research that, I know that these judges, these lawyers, these social workers know that children that's raised by single fathers have a much better chance of making it in society. They're less likely to be delinquents. They're less likely to abuse substance. They're less likely to drop out of high school. They're less likely to be violent offenders. So it's been proven that children reared by single women, these statistics soar out of control. And approximately, what, about 90% of people that's in prison was raised by single women. See, the facts are in. And you could deny where those statistics came from. They come from a place where you could go and look them up yourself, right? So we have to change this. Join my YouTube channel, A Spokesman for Men. If you're in some sort of legal trouble, there's nothing out there that's going to really help you. Tune into my YouTube channel. There's a faction of men, and we research these things to try to protect men. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, a spokesman for men and women that love them. And real sisters that love men, you could join it too. Share this video, spread it, because people out there need help. It may save a life. Too many brothers are committing suicide, and your color has nothing to do with this. that this thing that they've set up, it doesn't.